afternoon, everyone. This is Jeremy Medeiros speaking from Muncoach Island and joined by Lizzie Medeiros, who happens to be my daughter and everything. And she's actually back in Bermuda. She's from Barry College, Georgia, where she's studying biology. And she's here doing a study on bluebirds in Bermuda. So she's also helping me with some of the house chicks. She has so many of them. Plenty to go around, they say. But we're here on a beautiful day in Muncoach Island. I believe it's May the 15th. It's on May 15th. And this is a very special day because we're going to take out our Kahaukan chick, Sunny, today and give him his identification band on which he's going to be for the rest of his life, as well as the normal measurement check. So I think we're just going to get right into it. Waiting for us. Okay, so it hasn't been fed in the last two or three nights. That's totally normal. So 334 grams. And actually, I think what's starting to happen is starting to have his normal slim down period. Now, a lot of the chicks haven't been slimming down as they get older because their parents have been feeding them so much. They're just staying very fat right through, you know, almost to the point which normally they should be losing weight. And it's fine, it just means they're going to go out to sea a little later and they're going to just develop quicker that way. So we're just going to check his wing length, his outer wing length or wing cord. And we've really seen Sunny metamorphosize from a tiny little fluff ball. Yeah, you just have to, you're going to have to restrain him physically. He's quite a big, strong bird. Really grab and just pin that right to the river. Quite talkative too.
Mm-hmm. 206 millimeters.
Okay, that's good. So it's got a gang about 6 centimeters to go. So his wings are growing at about a centimeter every 2 days at this point, and so if you extrapolate that, they normally fledge when their wing cord reaches about 265 to 275 millimeters. So really, Sunny, it looks like Sunny's only about 12 to maybe 14 days away from fledging out to sea, so 2 weeks or less. So we're really in the final stage, it's past the three-quarter stage, and what you're going to see is him very rapidly losing all of that down over the next week or so. Okay, so at that point, I'm going to switch. And we are going to fit Sunny with his ID band. And we fit chicks that that are, you know, known age Cajals. We know how old they are and what nest they came from. We fit the bands on the left leg. Birds that we band as adults that we don't know their exact age, we always band on the right leg. And that's a very quick way of telling if you have a bird that, you know, we know the history of it, we know when it fledged, what nest it fledged from, who its parents were, and everything. It's a very quick way of being able to tell them apart. Still very downy, so you just use a special pliers to close up the band. Make sure it's completely closed. There, and his band number is E0618. So E0618, and that the bands are made from a special corrosion-resistant alloy called Incoloy. That they are designed to last for the entire life of the bird. And we know that Cajals can live at least 40 to 50 years, or maybe even more than that. So these things are good for half a century or more. And the amazing thing is, they'll still look absolutely new after decades and decades of being at sea with the bird in a very corrosive environment. Okay, so he is now banded, and we'll know forevermore, you know, if he returns, where he returns to, what nest, and how long it takes for him to do that. We can basically follow him now every year for the rest of his life. All we have to do is recapture him in whatever nest he decides to do. He's such a big, strong bird, he has a very good chance of surviving those, you know, 3 or 4 years out at sea before they mature, and hopefully returns to Nonsuch Island here to set up his own nest burrow and attract a mate to it. Okay, so we're just going to measure his bill length. This is very quick. Okay, yeah. It's definitely a male. His bill length is 29.4 millimeters. 29.4. So he's in that top percentile, so really, every single measurement we're doing now is confirming more and more that this is, in fact, another male bird. And the females tend to, their bill length at this point, tend to be about 26 to 27 millimeters in length. The males can be anywhere from, like, 28.8 up to over 32 millimeters. One bird we just checked had about 32.4 millimeters. And that's as long as an adult male Cajal. The only thing that'll happen is as they get older, their bill will thicken from top to bottom, but it's almost at the length it will be as an adult now. It won't get any longer. It's full length. This one might grow a little bit more before it fledges, but it'll fledge essentially at full weight. So, you see those long, lengthening wings. He still doesn't quite know what to do with them. He hasn't got them coordinated yet. But more and more he will as he gets the chance to start coming out at night and exercising these wings. And you can see his tail has still got a lot of down on it, but it's certainly emerging, getting quite long now. So I'd say plumage-wise, he is face, wings, and tail are pretty well down free now. The shoulder, not quite yet. It's getting thin, but it's still got a lot of down. So I think still just those three. Great, so yeah, so Sonny is looking good. He hasn't been fed for a few nights, so hopefully he will get fed in the next night or two. It may be partly because he's been very calm. The adults tend to like more wind to come in, but yeah, the bird continues to mature, and like I said, I would say probably by the end of the month, about the 28th or 30th of May, this bird will be departing Nonsuch Island, heading out to sea, and hopefully we'll see it again around about 2021 to 2022 when it returns to find its own nest and attract a mate to it. Okay, so Jeremy Medeiros and Lizzie Medeiros and Sonny and JP behind the camera lens there, all saying goodbye to everyone from Nonsuch Island. Everybody have a great day. Okay, you want to put them back in? Really nice.
I got to say. It's always the way it is, you know. Well, that little gimbal in theory is something for this, but it's just aspect when you... That's why at least you have to have a camera back there. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it's not good. Are you done?
That's it.
Okay, we can head back in here. Awesome. If you have other stuff to do, I'll run him back and come back and get you.
Sure.
What do you guys need to do now?
So we'll find this now. Bring 200 feet of hose.